and then everyone's connecting eyes except for you. You're like, when you're in the library or cubicle, I used to work in a cubicle, you know, making calls all day for 6 years. When you're in a cubicle, you're alone for 8 hours. No one comes in your area for 8 hours, right? You're alone. So you have some gas. You want to go all the way down to the hallway bathroom, so you decide to save time to release the gas. Right when you fart, someone comes walking in your area right there. Like your boss. And you're both ignoring that you're sniffing it. And man, just crazy stuff, you know. Like, I know there's a few of you here that are like me, you know, watching TV one day, and to my wife, I said, you know what, I like the smell of my old fart, all right? And then she's like, everybody does. I'm like, I knew it. Why did you tell me before? I felt like a freak. Guys, we're not very expressive beings, but we make the same expression when we smell that fart when we see a hot girl. Smell that fart like, ooh. See a hot girl like, ooh. But everything happens for a reason, and there's a reason why we're here tonight. It's going to be a beautiful night. Yeah, any preacher's kids? Any preacher's kids in here? Make some noise, preacher's kids? Those are the problem kids right there. Preacher's kids are messed up. Preacher's kid, and, you know, my dad passed away earlier this year. He was my hero, but he speaks to me in my dreams, and, like, my dad always said, everything happens for a reason. Everything happens for a reason. I always hear that. Everything happens for a reason. Growing up, I always used to think, does everything happen for a reason? Everything. Like when you're home alone and you stub your toe for 3 minutes, you're like, oh. When the pain goes away, you're like, what was the point of that? 3 minutes in my life, I'll never get back. You know, in ninth grade, you know, I was in church and, like, in front of all my friends, I was running and I fell on my face, but I didn't just fall, I was laughing goofy, like, I slammed my face, I chipped my crusty teeth right here, these are fake, you know. My mom was like, don't put cheap on your teeth, alright, these are permanent fixtures in your mouth, alright. When I was 21, my friends took me to my first rave techno club with black light. All the other people were glowing if they were these two people. Five kids, I have two older brothers, two older sisters, they're all 2 years apart, and I'm the fifth. I'm 10 years apart from my next brother, you know, so I always felt like an accident growing up. So, you know, in sixth grade, I went to my dad, I'm like, Papa, am I an accident? He said, there are no accidents in God's kingdom, only regret. So much money. My mom was like, you're not an accident. Condom broke. Yo, it's no accident that you guys are here today, man. Agents in the house, make some noise, yo. Coming up, man. We're coming up. Doing our thing, man. It's going to be a beautiful night. I want to introduce our judges.